Hi guys, hello, it's me, Ellen from The Winding Leaf, and today we are going to talk about easy care plans, or plans that don't give you so much trouble, that don't have a big attitude and are easy to enjoy and not stress about. I don't know if I put this up before or after my the video I filmed yesterday where I talk about all the fails, plant fails and dying leaves that are collecting on my floor. So I don't know, I need to, you know, see how I feel about it, but I wanted to do something more positive and show you all the plants that you can have that, you know, will thrive without, you don't need to, you know, have an army of humidifiers and the right light and the whatnot. They will just grow. And maybe, you know, it can be an inspiration for you to also try one of those plants, or especially if you're a beginner and just getting into the whole thing, watch out for those species. You will have an easy win with them. All right, let's start with my first plant that I want to show you. I'm starting with the most common of them all, I would say. This is also a very cool way to have them, I think. This is just a plain old Anthurium, the normal one. So not a King Anthurium, Queen Anthurium, crazy expensive plant that you know, need a research team to find. No, this is just the Anthurium that is on the market for the last, I don't know how many decades, that has either red or pink or white flowers. And what I did, because it was a little bit too boring to have her in a normal pot, I put this Anthurium, I don't know if you can see that, in a glass container, and she lives in water. So I did not, when I got her, she was normally in soil. I put her out of the soil, rinsed the soil off, put her in water, and she is thriving. And I think in this scenario, she looks much more interesting, much more jungly. So, normal Anthurium for a couple of euros, and you have your first experiment with letting a plant grow in water. So I would totally recommend doing that to change things up a bit. And also, you can have very cool decorations with this style of plant setup. My next easy care plant is the Philodendron micans. So this is maybe, depends on where you live. In Europe, they're quite common. Also, I will put a link down there where I got this nice specimen from. Not that expensive. Has velvety leaves. So, you know, if you want to step up your game and get into the whole velvety leaf thing, this is a very good Einstiegsplant or like starter plant for that. It can thrive on the lower end of medium light spots. Of course, if it has more light, it will grow more and you will see more, you know, movement on the plant. Needs normal water, trails away and looks very, very beautiful. So, Philodendron micans. Stay on the Philodendron road for a bit. The next is the Philodendron, the plain old Philodendron scardens. It's also another name I forgot. That you can buy, you know, in almost every plant center or Baumarkt or hardware store. And if you buy it as a small little plant, it will not cost, you know, the world. And then you just put it somewhere in a medium light. Water it regularly, depending on which pot it's in. I would always recommend terracotta pots, especially for small plants. Yeah, and then it grows. And then when it grows a lot, you just put a wooden stick in it and it will grow even more. So, you have those two philodendrons and then you have this specimen. This is basically the same. It's a trailing philodendron, but it has those cool yellow lime colored patches on the leaves. That's why it's called a Philodendron Brazil. It's also quite common, not that expensive. grows like wheat if you have it in the right spot and is very forgiving. If you need to water it, the leaves will look very wilty. I would not recommend, as a general rule, to follow the tip of my plants will tell me when I need to water them, because you can do more damage than good. I would rather recommend that you observe your plants, then see one or two times when it gets to the wilty leaf point, and then anticipate it for the next time and water them in time. You know, it's for me, it's like not a good idea to stress my plants unnecessarily just because I'm lazy or something like that. You know, you will remember if you don't have, you will not start with having 300 plants. You know, you start with like having 1, 2, 3, 10, 20, 30 plants, and I'm sure you can manage to think about watering them. So, this was my philodendron section, and what else did I show you? And one anthurium. I already showed you one anthurium. I'm going to show you another anthurium that is a little bit more rare, but right now, because the demand in summer was very high, everyone was crazy for it, was nowhere to be had, because nurseries need time to grow those plants, those it plants. And right now it's readily available on lots of websites and maybe also in your garden center. And it's this beautiful Anthurium claniverum. I think this time I said it correctly. Okay, so this plant in Germany cost like, this size cost like so 28, 30 euros. Looks very, very pretty. Has the velvety leaf and has also those like I don't know how to say in English, the Zeichnung on the leaf, that looks very extra. And mine also has like two long petioles, I believe. It has a little bit of a flower on it. So this plant looks totally impressive, and you think, oh my God, what do I need to do? Do I need to, you know, put her under special care? You don't. Mine stands in a medium to low light spot, gets water in this pot size once a week till every 8 days. So I check with my moisture meter, has a good draining philodendron monstera mix, but with, I would say, 50% of soil in it, and grows. Doesn't say a lot so far, but I saw, no, I didn't. I was just thinking maybe this is a new leaf coming. No, I expect this plant not to grow super fast, but it looks super pretty. So if you want to have a showstopper, your first showstopper plant that also has a nice Instagram moment feeling to it, go for this one. Don't be scared, it will not bite back. So now we are going to move on to plants that I would consider still easy care, but you need to know a little bit, you need to be a little bit more aware of how they look and where you put them. Yeah, so in this category I will show you three Calitheas or Maranta plants. This is the first one, and I would say in my experience, but this is like, you know, me living in Berlin, having a not so low humidity and good light situation, I would consider this my most easy to handle and to care for Calithia. That's a Calithia mosaica, because she has those, you know, like a computer graphic looking leaves. Super cool. I would say because the leaves are very thick, so when you touch them, they feel like fake leather. They are a little bit waxy on top, so they are not dainty little things like a Calithia Maui queen that I have, that you just need to look at her wrong and she, you know, all the leaves are flopping to the ground. This one looks hardy and also behaves more hardy and more forgiving. I have her in the medium light spot, in a terracotta pot, and I put my moisture meter in it. When it's at 3, I water her. So this is roughly once per week. And she is growing. This is really a good grower. So if you want a plant that looks impressive, it's not, you know, not run-of-the-mill, but still not crazy rare, then I would totally suggest this one. You will have lots of new growth. It will show you that it likes you. So you see, I'm now sitting in a jungle of Maranta and prayer plant leaves, and you think, oh my God, but mine are like not happening. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I think the trick is to not stress out about those. So this one is in a, I would say, even low light spot, growing very nicely, and the soil is has a good drainage to it. So I water my my two Marantas, I would say, every 3 to 4 days max. So they drink a lot of water. And I think this could be one of the points that you don't anticipate those to behave so differently than all of your other plants. So with those, please, please, please check with a moisture meter if you have one. Otherwise, put your thumb or your index finger very deep next to the root ball to check. In my experience, they need lots, also much more water than all of my other plants. In the evening, they will, you know, clap, put their little leaves up. That's why they are called prayer plants. And then they just, you can see, stretch out horizontally. So this is number one. And you all know how this looks. Also nowadays, not that expensive, easy to get. So try this plant, and this is the other one. So this is the green one that really grows like crazy. And here you can see the problems that lots of people have with their calatheas to various degrees is the brown tips at the end. And I think the brown tips are from overwatering them. So sometimes I didn't get it right. I watered too much, and then the brown leaves are start to happen. But you know, it is what it is. You know, if it's not half the plant brown, then don't stress about it. Also, it has so many new leaves, you know. It's growing pains. Yeah, so my prayer plants are in a medium light spot, not too warm, so not near to a heat source, and get watered every 3 to 4 days. So now up to the last three plants I want to show you. Look at this very nice pilea. This is the raindrop variety, I believe. I got her as a little plant before I even was so into plants. I just, you know, bought her at Lidl or Aldi or something when I was buying groceries and was just standing there as a tiny little plant and looked so pretty. And I fell in love. And then I brought her home and I watered her like I watered all my plants from growing up, you know, how I was did it with my mother. So like once a week I did this, and then all the leaves started to drop. Yeah, they started to yellow and then they started to drop, and I was like, what's happening? And then I realized, it took me a while, that this plant does not want to be watered so much. Now I know much, much more. So already when you buy this plant, it will probably be, oh, it also has a name on it. This is one of the rare occasions it not just says something, you know. But anyway, so it has this kind of earth. So you can see it's very chunky, has lots of coccocoia, I would assume, in it, and looks like an orchid bark mix. When you're starting with plants, you won't even know that there is a thing called orchid bark mix. So don't worry about that. Just it's chunky. It's not like normal dark soil. When you have plants like this, this is the first first suggestion or first like key clue that this might be a plant that does not want to sit in water. This is what is called a well-draining soil mixture. So if a plant like this, water her, I would say if you don't have a moisture meter and cannot check every 2 weeks for a start, especially if it's in this plastic nursery pot. If you water her more, or you know, don't have the game down from the beginning, those leaves will become yellow and then fall off. And if you see that, it's a clear indicator to like stay back from watering. And very, very important, just don't leave the plant, because you probably also have it in something like this. Remove the plant and there will probably be excess water in there, and just please dump it, yeah? All right, second to last easy care plant, in my opinion, under my circumstances, in my environment, is this very cool Raphitophoma tetrasperma plant that is more and more, you know, available, especially in Europe, in Germany. It's not that hard to get from online shops, and also if you buy it as a small, in a small size like this, will cost you like 10 to 15 euros. And the cool thing with that is that it has very, I think the leaf shape is so soothing. I don't know what it is. Monstera's, I love Monstera Deliciosa, please don't get me wrong, but they are more wild and adventurous looking leaves. Those, for some reason, when I look at them, has a very soothing, calming effect on me. Don't know if I sound crazy, please excuse me. probably because they are so round and I don't know. Okay, I'm rambling. Anyway, this plant, when the first leaf start to happen, will not have any fenestration. Fenestration is this like split leaf. And when it grows more and the leaves that start to develop when the plant is older, will look like that. This thing needs something to grow on, to climb on, to hang on. But for a start, it will be okay. It grows in a good speed. Also it does not take 500 years to do something. Sometimes it's hard to, especially to translate German Sprichwörter like sayings or geflügelte Wörter. I don't know how to translate any of this. Anyhow, that you see any progress. It needs a medium light spot, I would say. A bright light, not direct light to medium light spot. You can mist it once in a while, but you don't have to. It will also do fine without it. And depending on the soil mixture, just keep it not to dry out. Don't, you know, it does not want to soak in water all the time. So water it in a container like this. In a medium light spot, I would say once a week. If you have it under a grow light like me, I need to check a little bit. So it's probably every 4 to 5 days, I will put some water in here. So last but not least, I have an easy care plant that might be surprising for you. And it's this amazing Begonia maculata. And you know what? It looks super impressive, it looks super extra, and you think, oh my god, but you don't need to do anything with this plant. It grows, you know, and all the leaves that shoot out look like little aliens, you know, like this here, and have super weird forms when they like, you know, emerge, and then they just fold out, look pretty. I never had any leaf drop from this plant. You just water it when the earth is dry. So I would say it's right now still in the plastic nursery pot. So I would say even once per week is too much. So I just put moisture meter in, check if it hits the tree. This is a very hard number for me to say as a German. And then I put her under the water, or in water, because what happens is that this kind of soil, what they used here, is very, not chunky, but very hard. So when it dries, it gets very hard. When I just would water it normally, like the water would totally run through the soil and not hit any root. So it would not, you know, if this is like ready to be watered, this is a block, you know, it's hard. So what I do, I sit this plant in water for like 10 to 15 minutes, let it soak up, and then the earth gets nice and malleable, and then I know it's good for the next week till 10 days to go. But this is a very easy forgiving plant, so no need to fuss about it at all, but it looks super, super impressive. So I think the payoff with this plant is very good. All right, before we call it a day for today, I want to show you one little thing I'm working on for the last couple of months. And maybe you want to join in this scientific experiment. So those are two sweet potato tubers, I would say. Knolle in German. That I put into water and they are sprouting right now. And I... very excited to see how this develops, and for next year then I want to put them in soil and stuff like that. So this is how it looks. So I put two wood sticks in so they hang in water, and then you know all of those like very cool trailing things are start to happen. And this takes, also to get in this state took like at least four months, maybe even 5 months. So you can, I will make a video about this next year when I can show the whole journey. But already, if you want to, you know, join me on this train of botanical exploration, get yourself a sweet potato, put two sticks in it, put it in a water thingy, and then wait. It takes a while. It takes at least 1 month or 6 weeks before anything happens. Yeah, so I can totally highly recommend it. It will be fun to do that. When you can get where you live those Japanese violet sweet potatoes, it would be even better, because the foliage will also be violet looking, you know. This is in Germany we only have this variety, and this looks green. All right, so this was all for today. I wish you a very, very nice day. Thank you for watching. If you like the video, you know what to do, and I would say till next time, bye bye.